In the previous lecture, we studied about the contact potential across the depletion region, and we have obtained a relation for contact potential, that is V0 is equal to KT by Q, natural logarithm of NAND by NA square. So similarly, we have to find out the expression for depletion region width and the maximum electric field across the depletion region. So in this lecture, we will study about the electric field, potential and charge distribution at the PN junction. So one portion is over, that is the contact potential, and we have obtained the expression for contact potential. Similarly, and this is the PN junction diode, and minus XP0 and XN0, this shows the depletion region width. W is the depletion region width, where W is equal to XN0 plus XP0. So actually W is equal to XP0 plus XN0. So what is XN0 and XP0? So actually this is XN0, this point is XN0 and this point is minus XP0. XN0 is the depletion region width towards the end region. So XN0 means it is the depletion region that is penetrated towards the end side, and minus XP0 means it is the depletion region penetrating towards the P region. So this is marked as the x-axis. So this is point, so this is the x-axis, so this is x is equal to 0, and this point is XN0, and this point is minus XP0. So the difference XN0 minus XP0, that will give the value of W, that is W is equal to XP0 plus XN0. And this figure B shows the charge density distribution across the depletion region. So the total positive charge, that is across the XN0 width or XN0 depletion region. So we can see the total positive charge, and that total positive charge distribution is plotted here, and that is represented by Q plus. So Q plus is equal to Q into A into XN0 into ND. That is the total value of charge density, that is due to the plus ions. Due to the plus ions, the total charge density can be represented by Q into A into XN0 into ND. That is marked here, that is Q into A into XN0 into ND. Similarly, the total charge in the minus XP0, that is 0 to minus XP0 depletion region, that is that value will be represented by, that charge density value is represented by Q minus, that is equal to Q into A into XP0 into NA. So minus, so that is a negative value, the total negative charge at the XP0 depletion region. So this is positive value and this is negative value, and these two are the charge density values across the depletion region, and the magnitude of these two charges will be same, that is the total positive charge, the magnitude of total positive charge will be equal to the magnitude of negative charges. So we can write Q into A into XN0 into ND is equal to Q into A into XP0 into NA. Since magnitude is same, this minus sign will not be there. So the expression will become Q into A into XN0 into ND is equal to Q into A into XP0 into NA. So Q and A we can cancel. So we will get a condition, XN0 into ND is equal to XP0 into NA, where XN0 and XP0 are the penetration of depletion region towards the N side and P side. So we have obtained a relation, and we can call this relation as equation 1. Now we have to plot the electric field distribution across the depletion region. So this point is minus xp0 and this point is xn0, and this region is a neutral region. Similarly, this region is a neutral region. There is no potential difference, so the electric field value will be zero. So the electric field value will be zero at the edge of xn0 and at the edge of minus xp0. So the electric field will exist only in the depletion region where the barrier potential exists. So here a barrier potential exists, so we can measure an electric field. An electric field can be measured in the direction plus to minus, so that we already studied. So from plus potential to minus potential we can measure an electric field. So electric field exists only in the depletion region, and the value of electric field will be maximum at the center, that is at x is equal to 0. The value of electric field is maximum. At xn0 and xp0 the value will decrease and it will be 0. At xn0 the value of electric field will be 0. From this point it will be 0. So these regions are neutral regions, so the electric field value will be 0. So here we can see the distribution. This is electric field. So actually we are plotting the electric field distribution in the minus direction, on the negative quadrant. So that we will prove through the derivation. That is, we are getting the maximum value of electric field as a negative value, and the slope is also we will derive. And so at this point the electric field value is, so at this point electric field value is 0, and similarly at minus xp0 the electric field value will be 0, and at x is equal to 0 the value will be maximum, and this maximum value is represented by E0. So E0 means electric field maximum. So electric field is 0 at a point, that is very important. The electric field value will be 0 at xn0 and minus xp0. So the electric field will exist only in the depletion region, in the W width depletion region, and its value will be maximum at x is equal to 0. So this is the electric field distribution, and this is the charge density distribution. So we have obtained the equation for the total positive charge and total negative charge, and from that the magnitude will be same. The total positive charge, area of cross section also same. So the condition xn0 nd is equal to xp0 is na, that relation we have obtained. And now we are going to obtain the maximum value of electric field, that is epsilon 0 or E0 or epsilon 0. So this maximum value we are going to derive. So in order to obtain the electric field distribution, and we are using the Poisson's equation that we have already studied. Poisson's equation, actually Poisson's equation relates the gradient in electric field to charge density. So equation is dE of x by dx is equal to rho by epsilon. Epsilon is permittivity and rho is the charge density. So Poisson equation relates the gradient in electric field to charge density. This is the gradient in electric field. Gradient means d by dx of electric field E of x. So Poisson equation relates the gradient in electric field to charge density. Rho is the charge density, epsilon is the permittivity. So epsilon is permittivity, and rho is charge density, and E of x is electric field. So the electric field distribution is, we are going to obtain the value for maximum electric field from the using the Poisson equation. So this is the Poisson equation. For in semiconductors this Poisson equation can be represented as dE of x by dx is equal to, this is, rho can be written as q into from the charge density, we can write Q into the total charge present in a semiconductor, that is ND minus NA plus P minus N. So this is the total charge. So total charge means ND. ND is actually a positive charge and NA is a minus charge. So the total positive charge and the total negative charge. So ND and P, that are the positive charges. ND, the immobile ions, and P, the holes. So ND and P are positive charges. Similarly, NA and N are negative charges. NA means acceptor ions. N is electron concentration. So both are negative values. So this is minus and this is also minus. The total charge means total positive charge plus total negative charge. That will give the total charge. So total charge is total positive charge means ND plus P plus total negative charge means minus NA minus N. So this will give the total charge in a semiconductor multiplied with Q will give the charge density. So by epsilon. So Q into ND minus NA plus P minus N will give the value rho, rho or charge density. So this is the charge density by E epsilon. Epsilon means it is a permittivity. So this is the Poisson equation in the case of semiconductors. So here we have to derive the electric field distribution across the PN junction. So electric field exists only at the junction. So electric field is existing only at the depletion region. So here electric field exists only in this region. In the depletion region, there is no free charge carriers. No free charge carriers means there is no electron concentration, there is no hole concentration. Only minus ion and plus ions will exist in the space charge region or depletion region. So the value of P and N will be zero. Or from this equation we can write P minus N is equal to zero, since we are going to derive the electric field distribution across the depletion region. So in the depletion region, the value of P and N will be zero. P and N will be zero since there are no free charge carriers across the depletion region. So using this depletion approximation, so we can call it as a depletion approximation. So using depletion approximation. So what is depletion approximation? Depletion approximation means the electric field distribution across the depletion region, we have to consider only the value ND and NA since there are no free charge carriers. That is P minus N will be zero. P minus N will be zero. This condition is known as depletion approximation. So using depletion approximation, that is P minus N is equal to zero, we can write the Poisson equation as dE of x by dx is equal to Q by epsilon into ND minus NA plus P minus N. That value will be zero since ND and NA exist only in the depletion region. There will not be any electron concentration and hole concentration. So we can write this equation as equation 2. Equation 1 is xn0 into, so already we have written equation 1, that is this equation is known as equation 1. So this equation xn0 into nd is equal to xp0 into na, that condition is equation 1. And now this equation, this modified Poisson equation, can be written as equation number 2. So we can see in the depletion region, so this is the depletion region, minus plus region. So this point is xn0, this point is 0, and this point is minus xp0. So this is x. So this point is 0. So we can split this Poisson equation into two intervals. That is, the first interval is from 0 to xn0. So from this point, 0 to xn0. From 0 to xn0, there will be only donor ions. Plus ions will exist. So we can split the equation 2. So 2 implies dE of x by dx equal to q by epsilon into nd. Since n is 0 for the interval 0 to x and 0, there will not be any na or acceptor concentration. So this equation will become 0 less than x less than xn 0. From 0 to xn 0, this equation is q by epsilon into nd. Similarly, equation 2 implies dE of x by dx equal to minus q by epsilon into na. So for minus xp0, to 0, there will be only minus ions, so nd is absent. So nd will be 0 in equation 2. So minus q by epsilon into na. So from minus xp0 less than x less than 0. So we splitted the Poisson equation into two equations. So this is equation 3 and equation 4. So we have splitted equation 2 into 3 and 4 with the two boundary conditions, that is 0 x and 0 minus xp 0 to 0. So again, equation 3 can be written as, we are solving equation 3, that is dE of x and dx, on cross multiplying it will become q by epsilon into nd into dx. So this dx on cross multiplication, equation 3 can be written as q by epsilon nd into dx. So here we can see two variables. One is electric field E of x. dE of x means E of x is the variable on LHS and dx is the variable on RHS. So x is the variable and E of x is the variable on the LHS. So we can integrate this equation. So we are integrating this equation. So x with respect to x, here with respect to ex. And so we can see equation 3, x is varying from 0 to x and 0. So q, epsilon, nd are constant. So x is varying from 0 to x and 0. Similarly, e of x. What is the value of e of x? We know that at x and 0, the electric field value will be 0. Similarly, at minus xp0, electric field value will be 0. And at x is equal to 0, the electric field value will be maximum. That value is represented by E0 or EM. EM or E0, this is the maximum value. So we can write, so the lower limit is 0. At x is equal to 0, the electric field value will be maximum. So this should be similar. The lower limit should be, and the upper limit should be equivalent. So here it is 0. X is equal to 0 means electric field will be maximum. That is E0 or epsilon 0. And xn 0. At xn 0, the electric field value is 0. So we should give upper limit 0. So we are integrating. 1 dE of x means, 1 into dE of x means E of x. Limit 0 to, sorry, upper limit is 0 and this is E0, electric field, and this is equal to q by epsilon nd into 1 dx is again x, limit 0 to x and 0. So on solving, we will get 0 minus upper limit is 0, E0 electric field maximum, which is equal to q by epsilon nd into xn0 minus 0, which is equal to xn0. Or we can write E0 is equal to minus q by epsilon into nd into xn0. So this is the maximum value of electric field using the condition 0 to xn0. So this is maximum electric field. And equation 4 implies, from equation 4 again we can cross multiply this dx, so it will become dE of x is equal to minus q by epsilon na into dx. Again we are integrating with respect to ex and with respect to dx on right side. So here on the right side x is varying from minus xp 0 to 0. Equation 4, you can write here it is varying from minus xp 0 to 0, and dE of x, so at minus xp 0, at the edge of minus xp 0, the electric field value will be 0. So at minus xp 0, the electric field value will be 0, and at 0, the electric field value will be maximum, that is represented by E0. Again, on integration, 1 dE of x is E of x limit 0 to E0, which is equal to minus q by epsilon na into upper limit is 0. So this is x, so we can write in two steps. This is x limit minus xp 0 to 0. So on LHS it will become E0 is equal to minus q by epsilon na, upper limit is 0, minus minus xp 0. So again the equation become, this is plus, so minus q by epsilon na into xp 0. So we have obtained two relations for electric field, both are same relations. So maximum electric field, maximum electric field, we have obtained two relations. So this is one equation and this is another equation. So we can write both are electric field equation, electric field maximum value equations. So we can write E0 is equal to minus q by epsilon nd into xn0, and which is same as minus q by epsilon into nd into, sorry, na into xp0. So this is, we can write as equation 5. So this is the expression for, we have to study this equation. This is the expression for maximum electric field. So this is the expression for maximum electric field. So now again we can write, now we have to derive the potential distribution and the depletion region width across the depletion region width equation. So we know that electric field E of x is equal to minus dV of x by dx. This is the relation between electric field and electrostatic potential V of x. So we can write minus dV of x can be written as E of x into dx. So here we can consider V of x as the variable on left side and x as the variable on right side. So both are a function of x. So I am integrating this from minus xp 0 to xn 0. So x is changing from minus xp 0 to xn 0, that is the full width of the depletion region. So x is varying from minus xp 0 to xn 0. We already studied the potential distribution across the depletion region while deriving the contact potential. So here we can write, this is upon integration, minus xp0 means it is the, so this is minus xp0, minus xp0 means the depletion region towards the p side. So we can, the electrostatic potential on p side as, so this is the p side, since minus xp0 is a depletion region towards the p side. So here the electrostatic potential can be written as Vp, and towards the n side we can write it as Vn. So this already we studied. So towards the p side it is Vp, and the electrostatic potential towards the n side is Vn. So we can integrate for minus xp0 to xn0 on a, for the x value, and for Vx we are integrating. For minus xp0 we will write it is Vp, and for xn0 we will, corresponding to xn0 we will write it as Vn. So xp, Vp, xn, Vn, this is n side and this is p side. So this is the electrostatic potential differential distribution. So this is minus upon 1 dv of x is Vx. So V of x, Vn minus V, Vn, Vp. So we can write Vn minus Vp. So this is, we are not changing, minus xp0 to xn0 E of x dx. So this is minus of Vn minus Vp, which is equal to minus xp0 xn0 E of x dx. So this is minus V0 is equal to minus xp0 xn0 E of x dx. So we have already drawn the distribution graph, electric field distribution graph. So that is, so both the electric field equations are D is Poisson equation. So that is will be a slope equation, D E of x by dx. So this is the electric field value maximum E0. This is xn0. This is minus xp0 and this is 0. So actually this is Poisson value, that is slope value, gradient value. That is, this equation is 0 to xn0, that is dE of x by dx, that we have already splitted the Poisson equation into two. So this equation is dE of x by dx is equal to q by epsilon into xn0 into, so this is the equation, q by epsilon into nd. So this is q by epsilon into not xn0, it is nd. And this equation is d of x by dx equal to minus q by epsilon into Na. So these two are Poisson equation. So this is a slope equation. So that why this is, this distribution will look like a triangle. So we can write an area of a right angle triangle, area of right angle triangle in max, we can write it as half BH. Half is the base and H is the height of the triangle. So this is the general equation for a right angled triangle area. So similarly, here we are obtained an equation, that is equation number 6. This equation, equation number 6, that is minus V0. The minus value of contact potential is equal to integral minus xp0 to xn0 e of x dx. So this is minus xp0 to xn0 e of x. So this distribution is e of x. So we are plotting the e of x distribution with respect to x. So this is the area of a right angled triangle. So the RHS of equation 6 implies an area of right angled triangle. So minus V0 is equal to area of the electric field distribution, area under the electric field distribution. So we can write minus V0 is equal to area under the electric field distribution. So area will be equal to a right angled triangled area, that is half BH. Here B is this width, this is the base, minus xp0 to xn0. So minus xp0 to xn0 width is represented by W. W is equal to xn0 plus xp0. xp0 and xn0, the sum value will be equal to W. So this is the B value comparing to the area. This is the B value, or this is the width W. So half BH, B is W into H is the height of the triangle. Height of the triangle is the maximum value of electric field, that is E0. That is, we have obtained the negative value of contact potential is equal to area under the distribution, electric field distribution. So, and V0 can be written as, V0 can be written as minus half W into E0. So, substituting the value of electric field from equation 5, so electric field distribution, we can write any equation. So, minus half into W into what is E0. E0 is electric field maximum. E0 can be written as minus Q by epsilon ND into XN0. Or the other equation we can, NA into XP0. Minus Q by epsilon into NA into XP0. Any equation we can put. So I am putting minus Q by epsilon into ND into XN0 from equation 5. So this can be written as half into W into Q by, minus minus will become plus, XN0 into ND. So this is V0. So we have to, now we are going to derive, so potential distribution we have seen. So now we are going to obtain an expression for this W. Actually, we have, and we can write this equation as equation number 7. Also, we have W is equal to XN0 plus XP0. The two depletion region width summation will be the net width of the depletion region. So this is XN0 plus XP0. So from equation 1, we have already written equation 1. Equation 1 is XN0 into ND, which is equal to XP0 into NA. So from this, we can write, so equation 1 implies, from 1 implies XN0 into ND is equal to XP0 into NA. From this, what is the value of XP0? XP0 is equal to XN0 into ND by NA. So, substitute this equation for XP0. Substitute this value for XP0, then W will become XN0 plus XP0. Instead of XP0, we can write so instead of XP0, we can write W is equal to XN0 plus XP0. We will write XN0 into ND by NA. Therefore, we can write XN0 common. So, NA plus ND. NA plus ND by NA. That is W. Or we can write XN0 is equal to W into NA by NA plus ND. This is an important relation. So XN0 is equal to W into NA by NA plus ND. So we can write equation, substitute this value in XN equation 7. So what is the purpose of doing this? So we have to think equation. From equation 7, we know that there is a value XN0. That XN0 should be replaced. So we have written the value for W. W is equal to XN0 plus XP0. From equation 1, we can write XN0 into ND is equal to XP0 into NA. From that, find out the value of XP0. that xp0 is substituted here. So the full equation will be in terms of xn0. So from that xn0 we can find out. So xn0 value we should study, xn0 is equal to w into na by na plus nd. This value we will substitute it in equation 7. So here there is an xn0 part. So that value is replaced with this equation. So we can write equation 7 can be written as, so actually v0 is equal to half w equation 7. So what is equation 7? Equation 7 is half w into q by epsilon, q by epsilon, q by epsilon xn0 into nd. This is equation 7. So equation 7, so this is our equation 7, and we have obtained the value of xn0 as w into na by na plus nd. So we have obtained the value for w xn0, w into na by na plus nd. So that value we have to substitute in this equation. So here we will substitute and we will get v0 as w half into w into q by epsilon. Instead of xn0 we will write w into na by na plus nd into nd. So from this we will get half into w square q by epsilon na nd by na plus nd, that is v0. Then we can write the value for w as cross multiplying this 2 into v0 into epsilon by q na plus nd by na nd root, or we can write w as root of 2 epsilon v0 by q into this na plus nd by na nd can be written as 1 by na plus 1 by nd. So this equation is the expression for depletion region width. So here we already substituted for xn0. Similarly we can obtain the value for xp0 also. Xp0 is equal to w into nd by na plus nd. So this relation is also we can substitute if the other case is taken. So we have obtained the expression for depletion region width as w is equal to root of 2 epsilon v0. Epsilon is permittivity, v0 is contact potential, q is charge of electron, na nd donors and acceptors, nd donors, na is the acceptor ions. So this is the final expression for depletion region width. So for a PN junction we have studied the expression for contact potential. So this you should study the expression for contact potential, then the electric field density, electric field distribution. So the maximum value of electric field, this is the maximum value of electric field, then the total charge, the total positive charge and the total negative charge, then also the potential distribution, that is the minus V0 is equal to half into electric field maximum into width. Potential distribution equation also we have studied, and also and we have derived the depletion region equation, width equation, W is equal to root of 2 epsilon. So these equations you have to study. W is equal to root of 2 epsilon V0 by Q into 1 by Na plus 1 by nd. Next, in the coming lecture, we will study about the energy band diagram of biased conditions, that is forward biased and reverse biased condition. We already studied the energy band diagram for equilibrium conditions, so that we will study in the next lecture. And also after that we will study the ideal diode equation. So so with that the PN junction portion will be over. So that's for today. Thank you.